What is a clinical trial? Clinical trials are research studies that involve people. Through clinical trials, doctors find new ways to improve treatments and the quality of life for people with disease. Often, a clinical trial is used to learn if a new treatment is more effective and/or has less harmful side effects than the standard treatment. Researchers design cancer clinical trials to test new ways to treat cancer, find and diagnose cancer, prevent cancer, and manage symptoms of cancer and side effects from its treatment. A clinical trial is the final step in a long process that begins with research in a lab. Before any new treatment is used with people in clinical trials, researchers work for many years to understand its effects on cancer cells in the lab and sometimes in animals. They also try to figure out the side effects it may cause. Some clinical trials test ways to find a disease early, sometimes before there are symptoms. Still, others test ways to prevent a health problem. A clinical trial may also look at how to make life better for people living with a life-threatening disease or a chronic health problem. Clinical trials sometimes study the role of caregivers or support groups. There are several types of cancer clinical trials, including prevention trials, screening trials, treatment trials, and quality of life trials. Cancer prevention trials are studies involving healthy people. In most prevention trials, the people who take part either do not have cancer, but are at high risk for developing the disease, or have had cancer and are at risk for developing new cancer. These studies look at cancer risk and ways to reduce that risk. The goal of cancer screening trials is to test new ways to find the disease early, when it may be easily treated. An effective screening test will reduce the number of deaths from the cancer being screened. Researchers who conduct cancer screening studies want to know, does finding disease earlier, before people have any symptoms, save lives? Is one screening test better than another? Do large numbers of people who receive the screening test undergo unnecessary follow-up tests and procedures? Most cancer clinical trials are treatment studies that involve people who have cancer. These trials test new treatments or new ways of using existing treatments, such as new drugs, vaccines, approaches to surgery or radiation therapy, and combinations of treatments, including some that work to boost your immune system to help fight the cancer. Treatment trials are designed to answer questions such as, what is a safe dose of the new treatment? How should the new treatment be given? Does the new treatment help people with cancer live longer? Can the new treatment shrink tumors or prevent them from growing and spreading to new places in the body? Does the treatment allow a better quality of life with fewer side effects or help the treatment or help prevent the cancer from coming back once treatment is finished? Quality of life or supportive trials look at ways to improve the quality of life with cancer patients, especially those who have side effects from cancer and its treatment. They find ways to help people cope with pain, nutrition problems, infection, depression, and other health problems. These trials also might test activities, such as attending support groups, exercising, or talking with a counselor. Some trials test ways to help families and caregivers cope with their own needs, as well as those of the person with cancer. Why are clinical trials important? Today, people are living longer lives from successful cancer treatments that the result of past clinical trials. Through clinical trials, researchers and doctors determine whether new treatments are safe and effective and work better than current treatments. Clinical trials also help us find new ways to prevent and detect cancer. When someone takes part in a clinical trial, they add to our knowledge about cancer and help improve cancer care for future patients. Clinical trials are the key to making progress against cancer. These and many other common beliefs about clinical trials are simply not true. Myth number one, study participants are given placebo or a sugar pill. A placebo is a pill or liquid that does not contain any medication. Researchers never use sugar pills in place of the best known treatment for a given cancer. Patients who join clinical trials will never sacrifice quality of care. In prevention studies, it is possible to get a placebo. Treatment studies compare a new treatment to a standard treatment. Sometimes a standard treatment plus new treatment is compared to the standard treatment plus a placebo. Myth number two, study participation is for people without options. Sometimes clinical trials can be a last resort, but many times they simply involve a simple addition or adjustment to a standard treatment plan that can provide patients with a better quality of life or treatment options that may prove to be better than or boost the effectiveness of the standard of care. Clinical trial participation is for patients who have not yet been treated, for those whom standard treatments have not yet worked, and for those seeking different alternative care options. Myth number three, once people begin participation, they have to stay in the study. In view of historical abuses and laws in place to minimize abuses, it is important to note that every study participant can choose to withdraw even after having initially agreed to participate. At that point, their doctors can switch to the standard treatment for their condition. Myth number four, you will not be a guinea pig, but it's true that the purpose of a clinical trial is to answer a medical question. People who take part in clinical trials may need to do extra things or have certain tests done as part of the clinical trial. But this does not mean that you won't get excellent care while in the study. In fact, most people enrolled in clinical trials welcome the extra attention that they get from their cancer care team. You may ask yourself, why should I try something that researchers are not sure will work? That's a good question. Being part of a clinical trial may have risks, but may also have benefits. Some benefits of participating are an opportunity to play a more active role in your health. You may learn and adopt healthy behaviors that you did not have before. You may get a new treatment for a disease before it is available to everyone. And you may have the chance to help others get a better treatment for their health problems in the future. We will now go over some of the possible risks of clinical trial participation. The new treatment may not work, or it may not be better than the standard treatment. The clinical trial could inconvenience you. For example, medical appointments and tests could take a lot of time. The new treatment may cause side effects or be uncomfortable. In some trials, participants may not get individual results. It depends on the type of the trial. Before deciding to participate, carefully consider risks and possible benefits. Remember, a member of the research team will explain the study and answer any questions you might have. The specific risks associated with a research protocol are described in detail in the informed consent document, which participants are asked to consider and sign before participating in research. The goal of a clinical trial is to determine if these treatment, prevention, and behavior approaches are safe and effective. We do so by following an approved plan known as a protocol. A protocol is a plan that explains how the trial will work, what will be done during the trial, and why. Key information in a protocol includes the purpose of the study, who can participate, how many patients will participate, what tests patients will get and how often, what type of data will be collected. To make sure that participants are safe, researchers are required to follow strict rules. These rules are enforced by the federal government. As part of this process, an Institutional Review Board, or IRB, at each study site must be approved every clinical trial in the United States. The IRB is made up of doctors, scientists, and people like yourself, who are dedicated to making sure that the participants are not exposed to any unnecessary risks. They make sure that the risks or potential harm to participants are as low as possible. The Institutional Review Board we just discussed is one of the ways safeguards are in place to protect the health and safety of participants. There are other federal rules in place to help ensure the safety and ethics of clinical trials. Patients are protected through the informed consent process, careful review and approval of the clinical trial protocol by scientific experts and the IRB, and ongoing monitoring of the trial. Protection of patient health and safety also means research studies must take steps to ensure that your health information remains confidential. Lastly, Researchers have a moral obligation to protect participants and treat them humanely and ethically. The informed consent process also helps protect participants. Before joining a clinical trial, patients will be told what to expect as a participant and all the things that may happen. For example, someone from the research team will explain possible side effects or other risks of the treatment. As part of the informed consent process, a patient will have a chance to ask questions about the trial, both before they choose to join the study as well as while they're in the study. After getting all this information, a patient can think about whether or not they would like to participate. During the informed consent process, the research team first explains the purpose, procedures, and the risks and benefits. They will discuss the rights, including the right to make a decision about taking part or to leave the study at any time. Before agreeing to take part in a trial, patients have the right to learn about all treatment options, learn all that is involved, including details about treatment, tests, and possible risks and benefits, both hear and read the information in language they can understand. If the patient decides to join the trial, they will be giving an informed consent to sign. But even after a participant signs the consent form, they can leave the study at any time. It is important for clinical trials to include people from all backgrounds, as all populations of people experience illness and disease. Gender, race, ethnic origin, age, weight, and even where you live can lead to different responses to the same medication or treatment. When medications or treatments are studied in only one group, doctors will not know whether they are safe and/or effective for everyone. If a patient is thinking about joining a clinical trial, the best place to start is to talk with their doctor or another member of the healthcare team. He or she may be able to search for a trial, provide information, and answer questions to help decide about joining a clinical trial. If a patient decides to look for trials on their own, the NCI's Cancer Information Service can provide tailored clinical trial search that can be discussed with the patient's doctor. That service can be utilized by either calling 1-800-4-CANCER or at clinicaltrials.gov. If you are thinking about taking part in a clinical trial, be sure to ask your doctor, is there a clinical trial that I can join? Lastly, while joining a clinical trial might be scary, as you do not know how your body will react to a new treatment, conducting research in very organized, detailed methods is our best hope for advancing treatment and eventually finding a cure for cancer.